Hey, welcome back to PE. We are back and ready to talk about flexibility. Our essential question today is, what is flexibility and why is flexibility important? We're going to be doing some yoga poses and an activity for you, but just to talk a little bit about flexibility. Flexibility is the movement of your body, a full range of motion. We all want full range of motion in our body. This is something that we need to work on our whole life, or you lose it as you get older. It's very important to your health. So flexibility allows you to be able to move your arms in a full rotation, your neck, your hips, your legs, every joint that you have on your body. Get ready, we're gonna do our warm up. We're gonna start off with 20 seconds of high knees. Miss Sheely will start us off and we'll go.
Okay, today's activity is a Halloween yoga posing activity. So what we're gonna do, Mr. Bennett, Ms. Sheely, and myself are going to teach you 18 different Halloween poses. And at the end, after you've learned them all, we're gonna follow along with a video, a Halloween themed video. So the first pose is called the Haunted House Pose. And when you do the Haunted House Pose, here's what it looks like. Your arms straight up, together, feet are apart, just like that.
Okay, now we got the pumpkin. So the pumpkin, you're gonna sit down on the ground, get your legs together, arms around, head in.
Okay, now we're going to do the broomstick pose. So you need to lay down on your stomachs. You're going to put your hands at your side, and you're going to lift your legs and your chest off the ground.
Now we got the bat. It's your body, spread your legs, arms down.
Next we have the frog. So what you're going to do is you're gonna put your feet shoulder width apart, bend down, hands on the floor, and you're gonna jump up.
Okay, now we're going to do the cauldron or the witch's pot. So we're back down on our stomachs. We're going to grab at our feet or our ankles, and then we're going to bring our chest off the ground.
Now we got the witch.
Okay, now we have the cat. So you're down on your knees, and you put your hands on the ground, and you're going to arch your back. And then bring your head
Next we have the monster, legs are apart. You're gonna reach down and grab your ankles and you're gonna walk.
Okay, next we're going to do the spider. So this looks similar to what Mr. Kowalski was just doing, but we're gonna take our arms, we're actually gonna put our arms behind our legs. So you can grab onto your ankles or your feet and we're just gonna walk. There's a little spider for you.
We have the flying ghost. So you're gonna stand on one leg, arms out, lean forward, and flat those knees. Next up we have the moon. So we're gonna make ourselves a crescent moon. We're gonna put our feet together, hands above our head together. We're gonna lean to the side.
Next we're going to be an owl. So we're going to come down onto our knees and we're going to make a big motion up like we're flapping our wings and then we're gonna come down. So we're flying up and down.
For the skeleton, got the wolf. Woo! Now we got the snake.
To lay down onto our backs, keep your legs nice and straight. Our hands are going to come across our body and we're going to sit up just like a vampire would when he is waking up.
Next we have the zombie. You're going to put your arms out in front of you. I'm going to turn so you can see and you're going to kick your legs up. I am a zombie.
Pose. an eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the castle east,